Hello and welcome to the High Performance Research Computing instructional videos. Today we'll be talking about some of the basic commands that you'll need to properly run jobs on our clusters. Now, for those of you who didn't watch the SSH video, I recommend viewing that before because I'm just going to log in, just go straight in here. Just a reminder, we got our net ID at and then the host name, which today I'll be logging into Terra. Go ahead and hit enter, put in my password. And once again, we get the message of the day. Again, I highly recommend that you read through this and understand it before you go on to using the clusters. And those of you with an active allocation on HPRC's clusters know that you have multiple allocations. Usually when you apply for a basic account, you'll get one allocation of SUs for each cluster. And if you have SUs added on, you may end up with multiple allocations on the same cluster. So when you're running a job, you need to be sure to specify which allocation should be billed. And I'll go ahead and show you how to see which allocations you have. My project space dash L, which stands for list, that will go ahead and display all of the allocations that I've got on the Terra cluster. And you can see it displays some information about each allocation. You can see I've got two of them, one for last fiscal year and one for this fiscal year. It's got the account numbers here, which will be important here in a second. And note that only one of them is my default account. That is to say, if I run a job file, it'll automatically bill this account and not the other one. You can also see the remaining balance of SUs that you have. So let's say that you needed to bill a different account. You need to make a new account, your default. So let's go ahead and do that. We can do my project instead of dash L, we'll do dash D, which stands for default. And then we'll put in the account number of whichever account we want to make the new default, like this. And you can see it's now updated. And I'll just prove that to you by listing my project again. Okay, and you can see that it switched to the top one now. So this is very important for future reference. Once you start running jobs, make sure that your default account is set properly. And you'll also find that once you start running jobs, submitting job files, that there's actually a parameter where you can choose which account will be billed if you're not billing your default account. So in those cases, it is important to know how to use the My Project list to view those allocation numbers so that you can put them in that job file parameter. Okay, that's about all we're going to cover today on this video. Be sure to check out the others if you have any more questions. And also, please visit our Wiki, which contains text-based instructions for similar topics. The link for that will be provided in the description.